Hello, hello, my name is Sofia, and this is the walkthrough to OSINT exercise 006. On my website, you can find a number of OSINT exercises to practice your skills. If you have not attempted to solve this one yet, you can find the link in the description and give it a go first. If you're here because you have completed, well done, you should be very proud. If you're here because you want to find out how to solve it, I hope you find this video useful. So welcome to OSINT exercise 006. Task briefing. On January 19, 2023, a journalist with almost 140,000 followers on Twitter shared an image of a destroyed vehicle amidst a large cloud of smoke and fire. The tweet said, "Breaking. TTP carried out a suicide attack on a police post in Khyber city of Pakistan that killed three Pakistani police officers." The photo is not of the event described by the journalist. Your task is to verify the statement above. So I already told you, this photo does not belong to this event that the journalist described. You just need to prove it. You can click here to open the photo on a new tab. So if you click it, it's the photo on its own. You don't have the tweet. I marked this exercise level as easy for beginners and for experts. I would say it's quite straightforward, but it's very, very important skill. An important note, you do not need to find the author of the tweet seen below. This is censored. You do not need to find this person. Do not harass the journalist. Please do not be a dick. Okay. As I've said, this is a very easy exercise, but will help you practice one of the main skills you need to have in OSINT, data verification. You need to verify everything, even the most minute details. If it's in your report, it must be 100% factual. Unless you're writing a report on mis or disinformation, then examples like this are perfect. I wanted to select a tweet from a verified journalist or news agency. I have an add-on that tells me whether the blue tick is paid or not. So you can see here. I can show you the difference between this blue tick and a different paid one. So I have a screenshot. This is one that has paid. So this is a news agency. You don't need to know who is it, but they paid for it. So you can see there is a very clear difference. So this is a fully verified journalist. At some point, this meant something. It gave some sort of credibility and authority to user behind it. Almost 140,000 users follow this person and probably trust the information they share. It's a lot of responsibility. I'm in no way saying that they deliberately shared incorrect information. It's most likely that they didn't double check this photo that they either found or was sent. If you want to work in OSINT, this is something you should always be on the lookout. Often with big events like this suicide attack by the Pakistani Taliban, so you have here the TTP is the Pakistani Taliban, social media gets filled with photos and videos of the scene. Sometimes it's very clear that the data does not belong to the event described due to details in the scene. For example, you have photos where you can see snow, but then the incident allegedly took place in August in the Northern Hemisphere. Or there's a lot of light when it's supposed to have happened at nighttime, or people look like a different ethnicity than what you're expecting. Sometimes the data can be immediately discarded. Sometimes the data looks like this. So let's look at this photo now. It does look like this could be the location of a terrorist attack. Perhaps a suicide attack. At first glance, I would say it was more likely the result of an explosion by a VEID. So it's a vehicle-borne improvised explosive device. Quite a mouthful. You can see what looked like at some point a vehicle. It's pretty destroyed, so very likely contained a large amount of explosives inside. It does not discard the possibility of a suicide attack though. A person could have been inside to detonate it. In this case, unless you have a claim from a terrorist or remains of a body somewhere in the scene, always exciting, you probably won't be able to fully verify that this was a suicide attack. Anyway, enough of me talking about people exploding. I swear if you let me talk for long enough, I start talking about dead bodies. Okay, back to the exercise. The easiest way to verify photos such as this one is to do a simple image reverse search. I have an add-on that I showed in the previous video. So that one there, reverse image search. I can link it again in the description if you want to download this one. It allows me to do an image reverse search on the main search engines and TinEye. So very useful. So let's do a click all search engines, and you'll just search on all of them. And I can see if this image has been used in the past. So this already tells me that yes, there is no way this image is recent, because this was allegedly on January 19, 2023, so it's very unlikely that it would produce 377 results already. You can see I already have it sorted by oldest, and you have a few results. We can go with the first one. It's sponsored, but that's fine because it will probably give me some decent information. So what does it say? Look at that. Oh. It's almost like I'm paid to do this. Okay, 27 August 2006. So it's already old, isn't it? It says it's in Iraq, Baghdad, and look at that, a vehicle-borne improvised explosive device or car bomb after exploding on a street outside of the Al-Shaba newspaper. Probably an R missing there. So this is already enough information for you to answer the exercise. It's an easy exercise. This is enough for you to discard this photo as evidence on your report. This photo that was shared in January was clearly not taken in Pakistan on this date. So this photo is the same photos. This one with some sort of weird filter for some reason. If you scroll down, you will see there is more information. There's a lot more photos of this event. I want to make sure that you know that the photos are graphic. Some of them are graphic. So please don't look if you're not comfortable with that sort of image. And that is it. This is a very straightforward exercise. One of the main skills that you must have when working in OSINT is you verified everything. Even if it comes from someone that's verified as a journalist and has almost 140,000 followers. Don't trust anyone. I hope you found the video useful. Thank you for listening.